Hello, Gundam fans. This is Bram92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 Amazing Lev A parts. It was from the Gundam Ace magazine. I think it was a March 2015 release. Now there was the A parts and the D parts. The D parts came with the Dengeki Hobby. Makes sense. D Dengeki, A for Ace. Okay. And I think they both came with this. Now this is the beam rifle that the kit has, the standard, I guess, beam rifle. It looks pretty cool, little muzzle there. It can be held in the hand. I don't have the Vrabe. These kits were made for the Hainu Vrabe, which was one of the Meijin Kawaguchi's suits. I don't have it, but I have the new Gundam, or the Hainu, which is the original. And it does hold in the hand very snugly, pretty much as well as his normal beam rifle. Even though it doesn't have a peg, it's a little thicker, so it holds pretty well in the hand, and it looks okay. But you get this little attachment you peg into there, which means he has a mounted beam saber. And in the magazine, it shows green ones. I think the ones from Wing, but I use the 1100 ones, and they seem to hold okay. There are also ones you'd find in like the Trident 3 Double Zeta. Ones of the bigger beams. So that's kind of cool. But if you want, you can take this, and you have another attachment. You plug it into the bottom here, and now you have more of like a beam lance. Think of like I think it was the GM Striker. It was a two beam, but obviously you just have the one. And the beam emitter for the beam rifle will also take a beam. So there you go. So you got a lance. Kind of. But if you want to go a little crazier, you have a connector here, goes on the end. You take this, plug it in there, and now you have a double-sided beam staff. Kind of like an exaggerated version of the, the Strike Freedom or something. Yeah, this one here is a little different. It doesn't hold as well as that one, so I think this is a from another kit. I have so many beams. So you got that. Although, if you want, you can just peg the beam saber back into here for storage. So you have another beam saber attached to your beam lance, or whatever. So a lot of things you can do with this. And this actually fits into the holding hand. Like that. Rather nicely. And there's more. Now, if you want, you can take the end piece off. You can take that, the handle, the muzzle, and then you take the little front piece and the handle, and they actually, there's a little gap here, goes right in, and then you peg it right back on, and you get, now, these are the things I think that were different in the kits. The D parts came with like a kind of like a bean can. I think of like the Tullius 3 cannon. Or you get this, like a kind of like a bean machine gun, I would assume. And you plug it in and there you go. So now it is a machine gun. Pretty nice. I like it. Actually, this is why I got it, because of that. And then, you know, if you want, you can always take you can take the end there if you want. Or you just take the beam saber handle, peg it back in there, and there you go. So quite a few things you can do with the beam rifle alone. But then, you have the shield, which, if I bring in the normal Hainu shield, similar length and kind of similar design. Now this thing, you can actually mount the beam rifle on here. If you take off one of these, what will be legs later on, you can mount it right there. So if you had two, like both said, you'd have one here, one here. And to mount it on the Hainu, you have the adapter here, which it is rectangular, so it's not round, so really, if you get another connector that was actually round, you could probably fit it on another kit. Don't see why not. And it just plugs right into the arm. More or less. There we go. So now you have the shield on there. And actually, let me give him the beam rifle so you can get the full effect of these new parts. I believe if you have the Vrabe, there is a way to mount the shield onto the backpack in the middle, but I think also on the sides. But I've tried it without dismantling the fin funnel attachment. Can't really get that to work. But there you go. This thing's a little loose on mine. I think I need to tighten some parts. But anyways, there you go. Pretty cool. I got rid of the fin funnel just because it's easier to work with. Now, there's more you can do with the shield. Stay. Alright. So, I believe you could also mount this to other mobile suits, because these parts look very familiar. They look like connection points I have for adapters for other mobile suits and go into the back. It might work, so you can actually connect it to, like, a Strike or the Mark II or something like that. But I can't find them. They're in my perk container, and I cannot find them. So, yeah. But now, this thing actually transforms, so you can take these parts that were on, plug them in there. You can bend that up. Now these are parts here on a ball joint and a hinge. So you can bring them out. You bring them up, bring them down, doesn't matter. And then this part can move. And now you have a bird. Shield bird. Go. That's kind of cool. It's different, that's for sure. A little bird shield. We got like a little sensor there. And if you want, you can take the... Oops, no, I don't like those hands. Anyways, you can take the machine gun part and peg it into the neck. And then you can still have the normal muzzle of the beam rifle on here. Now, it doesn't really work with that on there as a shield. It pops it, you have to, it pushes the neck out of it. It's too close to the arm. You can do it, it's like that. So, yeah. But yeah, that is kind of cool. I like having a shield bird. It's different. So, let's get that back on there. Yeah, I don't like these hands. These kind of hands that you have to open up. They had a little T-pegs. I have quite a few that have broken over the years by switching the weapons out. I like it when the actual hand cover just comes off. A little easier to work with. So, that is the amazing Lev A parts for the Hainu Vrabe. Although it does work with the Hainu, and you can probably work with other kits if you just have to like modify it a little bit, maybe a different connector or the adapter for the back. But yeah, you got a lot of stuff you can make. A beam rifle, beam machine gun, beam saber, beam lance, double beam saber, you got the shield, you got a bird. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I wish I had done this earlier, like months ago, because they're not really, I don't think, in stock in many places. So you'd have to go on eBay to find them, hopefully without the magazine. Unless you really want the magazine, but the magazine means that it's going to be more shipping because they're heavy. So if you can, try to just get the box itself, because it's very light, just one plate. But I like it, and I want to get the other one now. So that is about it, and I'll see you in the next review.